where Jennifer attends and has served with us, and I'm privileged to lead Janice's memorial service here today. And I thank you on behalf of her family for coming and supporting the girls. If you hadn't guessed by now, Janice was a Barry Manilow fan, so we needed to honor her today in that way. You know, every time I speak to grieving families, I'm acutely aware that the expectation in everyone's heart is different. We all come from our own experiences, our own understandings, and our varied perspectives. But I'm also convinced that the promises from God Himself through the reading of Scripture does have the power to bring comfort and peace to us in our time of grief, because He sees and He cares and He promises. Therefore, I'd like to direct your hearts to a familiar, very favorite passage found in Psalm 23, and I'm just reading the first four verses. So familiar, the Lord is my shepherd, I have all that I need. He lets me rest in green meadows, He leads me beside peaceful streams, He renews my strength. He guides me along right paths, bringing honor to His name, even though I walk through the darkest valley, the valley of the shadow of death. I will not be afraid, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they protect and comfort me. These are some of the most familiar words that have ever been written, and certainly ring with courage as they carry such a deep meaning to all of us. The valley of the shadow of death looks different for different people. It represents the hardest times of life and the darkest nights of the soul and the deepest, loneliest places we pass through. Whatever creates a sense of hopelessness in an individual can be called the valley, this shadow in the valley. But there is hope that lies in that phrase, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You know, Julie, I have to thank you for reminding me of one of Gandalf's quotes from Lord of the Rings, because it says this very thing. He said, the journey doesn't end here. Death is just another path, one that we all must take. Profound. We are promised that everything God has revealed about Himself is true, even in the darkest times, even when life turns hard, even when we feel hopeless. Therefore, it is important for us to lean into the Apostle Paul's words written in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, and beginning in verse 16 to give context. This is why we never give up, he says. Though our bodies are dying, our spirits are being renewed day by day. For our present troubles are small and won't last very long, yet they produce for us a glory that vastly outweighs them and will last forever. See, we don't look at the troubles we can see now. Rather, we fix our gaze on things that cannot be seen, for the things we see now will soon be gone, but the things we cannot see will last forever. So may these words strengthen all of our hearts and bring peace to our souls as we celebrate Janice's life in these moments together. You know, her life, like every other life, was made up of seasons, moments of happiness and celebration and joy, and moments of disappointment and pain and grief. But the impact that she leaves on those that she loved and those who loved her will never be erased. I'm sure you girls have had a lot of time to share lots of memories as you've poured through the pictures and told the stories. This process will help you to realize how much her seasons meant to you individually and as sisters. I pray this time of closure that we now have and the time spent with your family later will continue to bring extra comfort and peace to your heart. You shared many of her seasons. She exhibited courage and strength and determination through her life. I'm sure of that. Her obituary reflects the meaningful time that she gave willingly to her family. Jennifer, you wrote, she was the best mom, wanted to be involved in everything we did, but in a good way. I liked you put that. She was always the supervisor of any project, and that made it more fun. There was a friend, Mariah Cheatham, who remembered her, and I read a note that said she was such a sweet person. She enjoyed her phone calls to Hobby Lobby, which made me think, huh, she must have relied heavily on that store. And I see that her craft, her love for crafts, certainly passed along in her daughter, Julie, here. What a beautiful tribute you made to her today, Julie. You know, the Bible actually has a name for what I've just described about Janice, and it actually uses the term seasons. And they define whatever her time here on earth was. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, beginning in verse 1, reads like this: for everything there is a season. There is a time for every activity under heaven. There is a time to be born, November 6, 1945. And there is a time to die, December 12, 2022. And then he goes on, he said, there's a time to cry and there's a time to laugh. I once read that crying is the way that your eyes speak when your mouth can't explain how broken your heart is. There's a time to cry. It's been recorded in scripture that even Jesus cried at the tomb of his friend Lazarus. And I like what one author wrote about that scene. He said he cried. He knew Lazarus was dead before he got the news, but still he cried. He knew Lazarus would be alive again in a matter of minutes, but still he cried. He knew death here is not forever. He knew eternity and the kingdom better than anyone else could. After all, he was the Son of God, yet he cried, he wept, because this world is full of pain and regret and loss and depression and devastation. He wept because knowing the end of the story doesn't mean that you can't cry at the sad parts. But on that day, it's recorded in John chapter 11 that Jesus promised these words to Lazarus' sister, which are true for us today. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die. The writer goes on, there's more. He said, there's a time to grieve and there is a time to dance. Grief never ends, but it changes. It's a passage. It is not a place where we stay. Grief is not a sign of weakness, nor is it a lack of faith. It is simply the price of love. So don't discount the impact and the necessity of grieving. It's necessary. Then the writer really changes the tune a little bit. And in verse 11, he says this: yet God has made everything beautiful for its own time. He has planted eternity in the human heart. Eternity in the human heart. It takes faith to believe that. For each of us, I'm sure that's very personal. The Bible says that if we have faith, even as tiny as a mustard seed, that God can grow that in a way to help us grapple with these deeper questions and thoughts about life. You know, 4 years ago, I traveled to Israel and I sat in the garden where Jesus prayed. And I looked on the outskirts of Jerusalem and I saw these giant plants. They just seemed almost like a tree. So I asked someone, what are those? He said, oh, he said, those are mustard plants. And immediately I thought, God can take a tiny mustard seed, even faith as tiny as that, and grow it into something as tall and strong as this? And so for most times that I officiate a service, I bring them. You can barely see them, can you? They're so tiny. Why would God ask us that even if you had faith as small as a mustard seed, it can grow to be that plant? So God will honor Janice's mustard seed of faith, however big, however small. That began many years ago, and he can for all of us. Because you see, faith doesn't always take you out of the problem. Some people think that, but faith takes you through the problem. And faith doesn't always take away the pain, but faith gives you the ability to handle the pain. And faith doesn't always take you out of the storm, does it? Sometimes faith takes you right through the storm. Everyone pretty much can come to grips with the understanding that our bodies will not live forever. They're only temporary. However, to believe that God planted eternity in our heart is just a little bit abstract. The short answer is that we're created with both a body and a soul. Our bodies will die, but our souls never will. The Bible isn't completely clear on all the hows of that, but there is a pretty good explanation found in 2 Corinthians, starting in chapter 5, that says, "For we know that when this earthly tent is taken down," that is, when we die and leave this earthly body, "we will have a house in heaven, an eternal body made for us by God himself and not by human kings." So if you're a person of faith right now and you believe beyond what your eyes can see, you eventually must trust that God's purpose and his perspective is different from ours, but his promises will always be true. And God still has plenty of purpose for all of you that are left. Your story is still being written. Your seasons are still being lived. So perhaps the poet Rachel Martin penned it best when she wrote this: "Today is a good day to be kind, to be brave, to see the good, to live with empathy, because today is a good day to be grateful, to let go, to help others, to be generous. Today is a good day to dare to try new things, to take action, to live with grace, to care, because today is a gift. That's why we call it the present." Janice's seasons down here are over. Her 77 years now define her space in the universe's giant calendar. She had a space, but your story and my story is still being written. So we make it count. We create more memories. We don't leave things unsaid. We live without regret. We make every choice carefully and with wisdom. And just because Janice's heart stopped beating doesn't mean your heart stopped loving. That's the beauty. Both of Janice's girls shared blessings. They wish to leave with all of us. They're beautiful. They tie together so well. It is fitting that we would close with them today. Julie's blessings are more about creation, and Jennifer's about the Creator, and they blend so beautifully together. Julie's leaves us with these two nature blessings. "May the longtime sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way home. And may the sun bring you new energy every day. And may this moon softly restore you by night. And may the rain wash away your worries. May the breeze blow new strength into your being. And may you walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days of your life." Jennifer has been singing a Matt Redman song as part of her healing and comfort, and we're actually going to close our service today with that song, 10,000 Reasons, right after I pray. Remember, girls, this, that there is an old Hebrew proverb that simply says, say not in grief that she is no more, but in thankfulness that she was. Both of you carry that in your heart, I know. And may Janice now rest in that perfect peace, knowing she was loved by her Creator and by her family and her friends. After I pray, we will have this song, and then Julie and Trevor are asking that all of you join them back at their house. And if you don't know where that house is, it's at 343 Charlotte. And we'll have a time of celebration to continue. So right now, I would ask that we pray together. Father, thank you for this moment in time. Yes, in the giant calendar of the universe, it is just a moment. But God, it's our moment. It's our moment to feel. It's our moment to grieve. It's our moment to laugh and to dance and to cry. All of the emotions, all of the feels. But it's good to be together, to be able to share that, Father. So I pray that as your comfort and peace rest on the hearts of each one of these that have come to pay their respects to Janice for the life that she has lived, a life well done, a life that is now part of eternity, I pray that you will give them a special measure of your peace, that they are comforted by the words and the presence of friends and family, and that they will sense there is still much more life to live, and may they live it fully and in your will. Father, thank you for this time to celebrate Janice, to give honor and tribute to her. Thank you for her legacy. Thank you for that she leaves behind, the footprints that will remain here because she was with us. We ask a blessing on the fellowship and the food that will be served shortly. And most of all, we thank you for Jesus, in whose name I pray. Amen.